Hi, my loves. Welcome back to the Stars Cartel channel. If you don't know, I'm Star. The message I heard is that's the best thing you can do. The scripture comes from Amos, Joel 3:19. But Egypt will be desolate, Edom a desert waste because of the violence done to the people of Judah, in whose land they shed innocent blood. In Amos 1:6, this is what the Lord says: for three sins of Gaza, even for four, I will not relent, because she took captive whole communities and sold them to Edom. God said, you know, for whoever this is for, it's like you are believing that. I just feel like you are nervous or you're scared that somebody will get away with taking something that belonged to you, regardless to what that something is, regardless to if it is an item, a job. Maybe you feel like a relationship is being taken over. Somebody's stealing your bestie, somebody's stealing your man, somebody's stealing your friend, somebody's stealing your girl, somebody's stealing this, that, and the third. Whatever it is, you feel like this is being taken from you. You feel like somebody's taking your job. You feel like somebody's over, you know, taking over whatever it is. You feel like somebody's taking over something. Like, you feel like it's being taken over. Regardless, you're like, yeah. God said, even like, you know, even if it's a situation, like if you feel like an apartment or a house or a car or like maybe you feel like somebody took your old seat, like you like sitting in a certain chair at school, at a university or something, I don't know, a hangout spot, I don't know, but I just feel like God said somebody, you feel like something was taken from you, God said he gonna judge accordingly. So it's not gonna be a situation with somebody that know they out of line and out of order, they not supposed to have whatever it is, or they not supposed, it's not supposed to be theirs, where it's gonna be okay for them to have it. Like, regardless if it's going to be a situation where them going around and actually, like, flaunting, like, let's say flaunting, like, let's say somebody steal your job and they were already working there. Now they got your job. Everybody looking for you and they keep on seeing them. They see them in your office. They see them at your desk. They like, what's going on? You know what I'm saying? And they may not rock with them as much because they notice that, okay, this is somebody that be taking people. Positions, I can't trust them, I can't rock with them. That is going to cause problems for them in the workplace. God says it's not going to be a situation. That's just like if somebody steal your man or somebody steal your girl, they gonna get a reputation of somebody that do stuff like that. Would you, like, I know me personally, if I know somebody that do stuff, I'm gonna look at you with a side eye because I don't trust you. Because if you will take such and such man, you take mine, and you know what I'm saying, and that's like, you know, I think it should be the same thing for a man. If you take such and such girl, you take mine. How can I trust you? You have no control, no self-control. You know what I'm saying? We can't rock with each other. And I just feel like God is saying when it comes down to it, he is going to judge accordingly. If whoever is in wrong, that's who's going to receive the wrath of God. And typically this wrath, I feel like, will come in the form of scrutiny. This wrath will come in the form of somebody being called out, put on blast, exposed for what they did, for their actions, for their ways. That's what God is saying. God said, can't nobody just take what belongs to you and it's okay. That's just like when people be, you know, thinking that they're going to be able to destiny swap with you. And it's like, even if they were to take your person, they were to live in your house, they were to start working at your job, and they were to start driving your car, it's not going to be a situation where they have completely taken your destiny as it is supposed to be, because their way of obtaining that is evil. It is wicked. So what God blessed, was he blessed it for you. He didn't bless it for them. And you know, God said he will bless those that bless us and curse those that curse us. So you have to understand, if God gave you a blessing and somebody is stealing that from you, do you really think that blessing is still a blessing? You think it's really going to be a blessing to that person? No, boo. It's a curse now. 444 as I say that. The same blessing, the same thing that was a blessing to one person can be a curse to somebody else. The same person that was a blessing to one person can be a curse to somebody else. The same car, the same house, the same shoes, the same purse, the same, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it is. That was a blessing to one can be a curse to another. And it depends on your heart and what you was doing. Now, I'm not talking about somebody, you know what I'm saying, that may, you know, have got, you know what I'm saying, they don't know what happened, or they found something, or somebody just gave them something, or, you know what I'm saying, they actually went and purchased something, and they didn't know this, that, and the third about it. God looks at the details, okay? I'm talking about somebody that deliberately is taking something from somebody else. They know what they're doing is wrong. They know it's not theirs. They know they're not supposed to have it, but they're taking it anyways. They're not, you know, like, they're not receiving this properly, and they're thinking that they're going to be able to get away with it. God said the very same thing that was a blessing to you is going to be a curse to them. And you know what I'm saying? And for some of y'all, it's going to be a curse to them until they let go of it. 555, as I say that. And that's what God said. God said because she took captive whole communities and sold them to Edom. God said somebody that took captive stuff that don't belong to them and acted as if it was theirs to give away, to sell, to use, to manipulate. God said he's seeking judgment, shame. Okay, shame, baby. Somebody said we need to bring back shame. Ooh, it's some people that really be, you know what I'm saying? It should be ashamed, baby. Shut the dog. Okay, shut the dog. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, share, subscribe.